good, everybody? It's your boy Everton. So today we're talking about Credit Karma money spend 6 months later. I've actually been with the service for a little bit more than 6 months, but my last video I made was about 6 months ago, so this is my follow-up video to that. And it's been an interesting experience because a couple things since I made that video have occurred. This right here is the debit card that they're going to send you out. It's a Visa debit card, or just like any other debit card. And I actually lost this debit card, or the original one, like right after I made the original video. So I did have to go through the replacement process of that. So I'll tell you guys about how that is handled and the things that they do to basically like protect your account while you're getting your new card. Secondly, I did have a return payment. So I'm gonna tell you, and it was totally my fault. Just wanna let you guys know about that. There was no funny business with Credit Karma on Credit Karma's side of it. It was basically me. I had a return payment. I'll tell you guys how they handle that because they do offer, they say that they have no fees and et cetera. So I'm gonna tell you guys about that as well as some of the other features that they offer and tell you guys my overall analysis of the service. So let's go ahead and get into it. So what is Credit Karma Money Spend? Credit Karma Money Spend is an online checking account service that Credit Karma, the credit monitoring service, offers. So they give you access to a routing number and an account number so you guys can process ACH payments like online checks and things like that. They also do give you that debit card so that way you guys can terminal purchases and things like that, as well as withdraw from ATMs that take Visa. They are a part of the Allpoint network, which has about 55,000 ATMs in the United States. So that way you can, you know, basically make unlimited withdrawals from the Allpoint network for free. So after you set up your Credit Karma account, you'll be initially asked to do your initial funding, which is linked through another bank account. So you have to have a routing account number from another bank and then you can fund it through there. Now, funding did take me about a week originally, but from there you can continue to fund through other banking accounts or you can have direct deposit set up. Any funding of your account will have to be done electronically. You can't go to like an ATM to deposit cash, etc. I'm not gonna lie, I haven't used cash in like years now, so but just know that you have to fund through an external source. Now I do have my account currently set up where it gets money from my actual job, and I've always been getting my deposit into my Credit Karma account like 2 days early. Recently I got it like 3 days early because of Veterans Day was recently, so due to the banking holiday, etc., they pushed it out an actual day earlier, which was really nice to know that you can get your funds a little bit early. Now, the way I used to use my account was I used to just put $50 in there, and that's it when I initially got the account because I wanted just some extra spending money to hold me over, to give me like a couple of days before like the rest of my paycheck hit and my other financial institutions. I have since changed that. Now I use a service to basically pay for my gym membership, and I just have, you know, my other money going out to my other banking accounts that I have. And it's been working out pretty fine. So for the most part though, it is pretty convenient. I've had a consistent amount of money always going there, and it's been from guaranteed sources, so haven't had any holdup with funds or anything like that. But I did lose the card, like I said, after I made their initial video or initial review, and the replacement was pretty easy. I just did it through the app where you can request a new card. They ask you to confirm the mailing address and they send out a new card to you. You also do have the ability to lock the card and to change your PIN all throughout the app, so which is very convenient. You can do that. You can do that on the go. As long as you have your smartphone with you, you can basically lock it down that way. Now, once they do issue a new card, you can add that card to GPay almost immediately after they issue the new card and the new information. So that way you can continue to use your account securely through GPay or Apple Pay, which I'm a frequent user of. So the shipping process, it actually took about a week, which is significantly, it was like 50% shorter than the original time it took to get my original card. And I think it's probably because of the online setup process to maybe take a little bit longer. But once you have your account established, at least for me, it took about a week to get my replacement card. But once again, they allow you to add it to GPay or Apple Pay almost immediately, so that worked out pretty fine. The second thing that did happen to me was I did have a return payment, like I said. So basically I get direct deposit set up where it sends about like just enough to cover my gym membership, maybe like a couple of dollars more. And what happened was I was going through a drive-through and I was paying through an app, and I paid through Apple Pay. And Apple Pay, it presented my Credit Karma. By the time I knew it, it had already taken it out. Totally my fault. It's all good though. So, you know, the next day, my gym membership tried to take out the amount of money for my gym membership. Now, granted, I told you guys that I only have enough money in there to cover my gym membership. So obviously, when the funds came out or attempted to come out, I didn't have enough funds in there to cover it. Now, the thing about Credit Karma is that they do say that they don't have any fees at all. So there's no online fee, there's no NSF fee, there's no overdraft, no fees at all. But they also don't guarantee that they will cover any like payments that attempt to go through. So the way that mine actually occurred was that they actually reversed the payment. So it originally attempted to post, they reversed it. So instead of giving the code, and there are different codes that banks will respond to say, hey, we don't have the money. It could be not sufficient funds, it could be no account located, or it could be a reversal of payment. They did a reversal of payment, which was actually a little bit cooler for me, right? That is a way that we avoid like the non-sufficient funds. But on the drafter side, which means like the bank that my gym uses to process their transactions, they did not get an NSF like notification, which didn't trigger for them to charge me a non-sufficient funds fee, right? Which was amazing for me. So I made it out without paying any fees, and they took the payment from a backup account, which is cool. So it all worked out, but I'm not gonna lie, my preference would have been for them to like spot me the funds and then let the deposit that would have came through later, you know, basically cover that. I know it's a big risk. I know it's a big ask, but you know, that would have made the transaction a little bit easier. But once again, I came out of it okay because they didn't charge me any non-sufficient funds fee like they said they wouldn't. And also the code that they sent back to the drafter's bank didn't initiate an overdraft fee for me as well. So I think that's a huge bonus. So next thing I want to talk about is Instant Karma. So Instant Karma is basically a perk that they have for the service where they will actually give you guys back, like they will reimburse you for purchases that you make with a debit card. Now, personally, I have not been selected to have my purchases or anything like that being reimbursed, but I do use my card very seldomly. Once again, I only have a 1 month transaction for the most part, except for the time when I used to like use it for a little bit of spending money, but I wasn't using the card that much. So I'm not the best person to have to be selected because I rarely use a card, but I will say that it's a pretty nifty thing, and it does range from, sometimes I'll see stuff that's like $2. Sometimes I'll see transaction being reimbursed for like 18 bucks, like some significant amount of funds that you can get back. Especially like a free tank of gas, if they were to reimburse you for that, that would be pretty cool. And they actually show you the active winners. And some people have won like a lot of times, all right? The one thing I will say that I did notice is that when I did my original video, I actually paid attention to the amount of money that they were giving back. And 6 months ago, they actually said in the last 30 days, we gave back $1 million. When I checked today, it said they gave back in the last 30 days, $275,000, which means, well, it could mean like three things, right? Number one, well, they're giving back less money, but like, what does that mean, right? It could be that spending is down, right, on that platform or in that service, meaning that people aren't spending as much money, so they have the opportunity to reimburse less, right? Secondly, it could mean that there are less people on the platform than prior before, right? Or on the start using their services. So also, you know, they have less opportunity to, you know, give back less. Or they're just giving back less money, right? Like they're like the frequency in which they're choosing to give Instant Karma winners is just less. They're just giving back less money. Either way, it's drastic. It's like a 75%, almost a 75% drop off from where they were 6 months ago with giving back. It doesn't really mean anything to me personally. I mean, I really haven't gotten any Credit Karma, Instant Karma reimbursements, but it is something to take note of that doesn't seem to be as robust as it was before. So what is my overall analysis of Credit Karma money spend? Well, I actually think it solves a problem, especially in rural areas where certain communities don't have access to like financial institutions, and it gives certain demographics or certain locations access to, you know, do online checks, shop online, and, you know, gather things that would not be as easily attained from, you know, in other communities, right? So I actually think it's a really, really good like solution. And there are multiple online banks that do this as well. You have like Chime and Simple and other things like that. So I think it's another great option. I do like their approach to Credit Karma. It's a nice, or Instant Karma, which is a nice spin on cashback, encourages engagement and use of, you know, the payment. So I think it's pretty cool. But I will say that I've been in the banking industry for about, I think like early to like single digit 2000, maybe like 2007. And I can definitely tell you that with these third party companies that partner with banks, there's typically like what they have to do is they have to adhere to not only like the standards of, well, whatever the originating bank or the bank that they're partnering with, they have to adhere to their standards, but that bank will have to also implement their own stricter, tighter regulations to make sure that they can keep the financial institution that's backing them, that their relationship is pretty good. So usually some more restrictive, which is why they don't have overdraft fees and et cetera like that, because you don't have a really direct consumer relationship. So with the actual issuing bank, therefore, overdraft, they're not really willing to spot you the funds as much like that. They will say, hey, we're not gonna cover it, et cetera like that. I think where the problem comes in is that a lot of times you don't have a lot of subject matter experts if you run into an issue with your account, right? Because they're not really a financial institution. They're like a servicing third party that allows you to use the Credit Karma spend money spend platform. And then, you know, when, if you run into an issue, I've heard some very, very, very bad stories about like how, you know, horrible it is to deal with customer service. Now things are all fine and dandy until you run into an issue. So if you have like some type of non-traditional source of income that, let's just say you did Uber, and one day you can have $800 deposit, the next day or the next 5 days you can have $200. That volatility in funds can sometimes trigger like fraud, right? Like it can, and sometimes, you know, these systems are built on like identifiers, right? And sometimes it can cause your money to be locked up. And if you're calling someone who isn't really a subject matter expert or is familiar with these type of industries, sometimes it's a little bit more difficult to get a resolution. I've read a lot of bad stories online. But if you do have some pretty consistent income, such as like you just have a 9-to-5 job, your paychecks are $1,000 every time you get paid, or $2,000 every time you get paid, something consistent, and you know, you probably won't have that volatility or those, you know, those risky indicators, I think this is a great solution. I think it's a great solution regardless, right? Even if you had those scenarios, it's just that you do want to be mindful of like, hey, this is a third party bank or a third party service that you're dealing with that has a relationship with another bank, and there's all types of regulations that you might have to run into. But if you're kind of one of those consistent people, I think this is a great option, especially if you don't have access to like larger financial institutions, or if your budget is kind of like a little bit smaller and then you have to pay for banking fees, this is a free option for you, and it gives you access to like 80% of all the banking services that they do, that the big banks offer. So it's a pretty good toss up there. But either way, guys, that's been my analysis on Credit Karma Money Spend. Hopefully you guys learned a lot. If you guys have any questions, please leave them in the comments. And there is a link to Credit Karma Money Spend in the description. If you do want to go ahead and check them out, you can click on that. It'll take you right down to the app and you can download it and check it out. All right. Until next time, I'm Everton, and I do videos Everton's way. Peace.